Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a really simple fillable form, and then I'm going to save it and show you how your user will use it. So I'm just going to make a quick form. Just going to go to Insert, Table, and in here you'll just select the rows and columns that you need for your fillable form. Sometimes it takes a bit of nurturing, but this is just going to be a very simple form. So I've got my table here. I'm just going to drag over that middle section so I can put my questions on the left here. I'm just going to make these rows a little bit taller. So I'm going to select my table by clicking on this square up here. Go to Layout. Go to Height here. I'm just going to select it and click 1. Press Enter. And then I want everything to lie to the middle and left. So align to center left. Click on that one. And then we can start entering in our document information. Okay, I'm just going to adjust this row here. I'm going to select it all. I'm going to hover over that middle section. I'm just going to pull that over to the right just to extend that out so that that question is on a single line. And do the same with this one here. Just pull that one out. You can keep them all the same width if you want to, but I'm just going to show you how to do it with this particular demonstration. So you've got some questions in here, and we're going to utilize various different ways in which these questions can be answered. So in order to do that, you need the developer tab in your software. Now, if you don't have that, just go up to Word, go to Preferences, go to Toolbar and Ribbon, or Ribbon and Toolbars, and then on the main tabs here, just go down to the bottom where it says Developer and make sure it's checked. Once it's checked, it will appear in your tabs across the top here. So if we go to the developer tab, this section here will deal with your fillable forms. The first box is related to a text box, so where you want somebody just to enter in some text. The second one is a checkbox, where you want them to answer yes or no. The third box is a combination box, which will give you a drop-down menu. This section here will give you a frame if you want somebody to enter in a photograph. Then the shading relates to the boxes that you will create. And the protect form is the one that you will click so that your user cannot adjust the remainder of the form and will only be able to type where you've placed your fields. So in the first box, we'll enter a text box. So just click on text box. And as you can see here, we've now got a gray box. Now you can type in that at the moment, but it will delete it. So what we need to do for your user to be able to use it is to click the protect form. If you click the protect form, if I try to place my cursor anywhere else on this document, it will simply jump into this box here. Then your user can go ahead and type, and then we can also do that for the surname, but we have to go back and unprotect the form. Go to surname, click text box, and again, you've got a text box there. You can get rid of this shading if you want to by clicking this box here, but I find it's quite helpful just to have that shading so that your user knows where they should be typing. Now, sometimes you may have a fairly small box and you don't want your user to type any more than will fill up the box. You don't want them to type so that it nudges to the next line down. So you can specify the amount of characters that your user places in this box. If you click on that box there and just right click, go down to properties, and this is the properties of your text form field. So you can adjust the text if you want to. You can put it as a number, date, or currency. And here you can select whether they have unlimited text or they have a specific text. So you can select one character, two characters. So if we were just to say 20 characters and then just click OK, it means that when we protect the form, when your user types in this box, when you get to 20, you can see I'm typing but nothing's happening because that's restricted to just 20 characters. Go back up and unprotect the form. And then in this box here, we will have a yes and no answer. So we can just type here yes. And then a few spaces. Then go up and place a checkbox in. Then a few more spaces. Type no. A few more spaces. And then just click checkbox. And once again, at the moment, we won't be able to select those or cross them out. But if we protect the form, So once we've protected the form, we can then go inside and click on the box, and you can see the cross will appear. Unprotect the form, and then we can go into this section here, and then we can add a combination box. Select this box here, and then for this one, if we right click, go down to properties, and you can see we have now a different menu. So you now enter in all the different options you want in your drop down menu. So let's say we put in management, then go down to this plus sign here and add it to our list. Once you've added the selections that you want, you now need to place a title in here. So normally you'd find something like please select. Add it to your list, but make sure the please select is at the top of the list. Select it, go to the arrow key here, and then just make sure you keep clicking it until please select is at the very top, and then click OK. In the bookmark, we can just name it employment, and then click OK. And as you can see now, we've got a menu here which is saying please select. Again, let's protect the form. We've got a little drop down arrow here. So if I click on it, you can see I can select any of these options. Okay, so once you're happy with your form, go to File, Save As. I'm going to save mine to my desktop. I'm going to call it Form. And I'm going to save this as a Word document and just click Save. So now when I open my form, you can see it's my new form because its name at the top here is Form. So I'm now the user of this form. So now I can just go in and just type in all my details, and I can uncheck this box if I want to, click the other box. I did save it with the cross inside, but it doesn't really matter. And then again, the drop down here, please select, and then you can just select one of those. Then once they've completed the form, they can just simply save it and send it back. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.